Blessed are the cheesemakers. Well, that was Monty Python's take on the Beatitudes, but it's fair to say those involved in Hohepa, a small Hawke's Bay cheesery, are considered particularly blessed. They started out making cheese there for the intellectually disabled residents and have already scooped up numerous awards, and last night at the Cuisine Champions of Cheese Awards took away a bronze medal for this year's feta. So what's their secret? Corinne Embler at Hohepa of Hawke's Bay.
It's a tough job, but someone's got to do it.
Strong, delicious.
It's strong.
The more you eat, the more the flavour comes out.
And tasting it is all the better when you know it's won awards, as this Hohepa Tasty has.
Last year we won a gold medal with cheese.
Brazilian cheesemaker Inácio Guimarães started making cheese on his parents' farm as a child and came to work at Hohepa 17 years ago through his interest in organic farming. He says many factors play a part in Hohepa cheese tasting so good.
We are lucky to be working in a 50-year-old biodynamic farm in New Zealand. So it's been organic for a long, long time. And we also have got a very special breed of cattle, Shorthorns.
The Shorthorn we've chosen mainly for three reasons. One, it's very placid. Two, the cow itself actually has a very nice balanced milk between the fat and the protein is very nice balanced. And the cow is also very versatile. It's actually a cow that can be eaten for meat and also for milk production.
Farm workers know every one of these cows by name. What helps their milk taste so good is the organic preparation used to fertilise the soil and the nutritious herbs grown in the pasture.
Do you have a name for her?
Jersey.
You just call her Jersey?
This one's Spotty.
As well as being a commercial operation, the cheese-making process at Hohepa is used as therapy for the residents. It gives those like James a daily purpose and a shared ownership of the product.
Why do you think your cow's cheese tastes so good?
Oh, the cheese is different than normal cheese. Oh.
Right next door to the milking shed is Inácio's cheesery. Today he's making Danbo, sometimes called butter cheese, for its soft, creamy texture.
It's almost ready to cut. So when it's that stage, I'm going to cut it and make it into little cubes.
Do you yourself have any particular rituals of your own when you're making the cheese?
I sing to the cheese.
You sing? What do you sing to it?
Oh, lovely songs. And I think it's quite important that you feel happy and at peace when you're making one product, because people, we're going to eat it.
Wow, that's my idea of heaven. Look at it all.
He says an important part of his job is providing therapy for the residents and teaching them new skills.
They're great. They're very good helpers. Yeah. Obviously, you have to supervise, but once they're trained on what to do, they do very well.
Why do you turn the cheese and why do you clean it?
To try to get the mould off.
Do you know that your cheese wins awards?
Yes, I do.
And you're part of the team that makes it?
Yes.
How does that make you feel?
Good.
Assistant cheesemaker Chaz Greeley is putting the final touches to a batch of feta.
And what does the salt do to the cheese?
Gives it a lot more flavour and draws some more of the moisture out to harden them up a bit.
This was the country's top feta 2 years ago, and though they don't know it yet, it's won bronze at this year's Cheese Awards.
It's a very good cheese as well, you know, very tasty cheese.
The money generated from the cheesery and from the farm and the vegetables all goes on to help support the community. We've got some quite major building projects underway and we have to find capital money ourselves.
The word has got out and now the Hohepa shop does a roaring trade, selling excess cheese, milk, meat and veggies. The money helps with the upkeep of the 120 residents and gives them all meaningful work.
A real sense of pride. I mean, our aim for anyone during the day is that they get some sort of fulfilment, whether it's making candles, weaving, felt making, and with the cheese making, they are very, very proud of being involved with it.
What's your favourite cheese at this place?
My favourite cheese is mozzarella.
Are you proud of yourself?
Yep, I'm proud of myself.
And in keeping with their environmentally friendly principles, Hohepa Cheese uses no carbon miles. The furthest it travels is a few hundred metres to the on-site shop.
Well, certainly none travelled up here after Corrine did that story. It looks delicious. International Master Judge Neil Willman says Hohepa's cheeses are luscious, rich and creamy. And it's obvious they work with high-quality milk and a great deal of passion. And that's New Zealand Close Up.